Congressman, the president is headed to meet with Russian President Vladimir Putin in just 2 days in Helsinki. What are you hoping the president says to President Putin?
Well, I'd like to see him, and I'm pretty sure that he will discuss a few topics. Number one, you obviously have nuclear proliferation and arms race, stuff like that. You have Syria. We're conflicting with Russia in Syria, but there's a next phase there. We have to contain Iran, so he's got to deal with that. Election meddling, I know that's on a lot of people's minds. He should discuss that. Ukraine, Crimea. So there's a few things, topics that he could speak to. Although I'm not sure that there will be something groundbreaking coming out of this meeting. I don't have expectations that there will be, but if there is, then fantastic.
$34 billion in additional funding is what the president says he's been able to secure with NATO. And you've watched as the president has been traveling throughout Europe ahead of this meeting in Helsinki. What do you make of how the president is representing the U.S. on his overseas trip?
So I think a lot of Americans and both President Obama and President Bush thought the same thing of this president, that our allies have to pay a little bit more of their own defense, right? I think President Obama said they were freeloaders or free riders, excuse me. I think that's a little strong language too. But the reality is that it is an uncomfortable truth. And sometimes you have to have tough conversations with your families and your friends and your allies. So I think the president is doing that. And Americans largely believe in the same thing, that Europe should spend a little bit more on their defense. And that's a good thing. That'll make all of us stronger.
Earlier today, President Trump giving a press conference with UK Prime Minister Theresa May. They talked about this special relationship. However, the president did seemingly have some critical words for the UK Prime Minister. What do you make, again, of how the president is heading into Monday's meeting with President Putin? Is he coming at this from a position of strength, or is there disunification amongst traditional American allies?
I think it's a separate thing. I know that there's been a lot of reporting out there that tries to say, okay, because the president's having tough conversations with Europe with some uncomfortable truths that we all acknowledge, that therefore he would not be strong in a meeting with Putin. I actually disagree with that. I just do. But look, I don't agree with the president sometimes stylistically, for sure, but I do agree that Europe should spend more in their defense, just like President Obama and President Bush before him. So I agree with those things. I do agree that the president should take a tough stance with Vladimir Putin on things like election meddling, as well as Ukraine, as well as Syria. I think that he should, and I'm hopeful that he will, and I wish him success, as should every American that's out there, because if his success is our success.
With regards to energy policy, particularly in Europe and with regards to Russia, what did you make of the president commenting, pushing back on not just Prime Minister May, but also Chancellor Merkel with regards to their energy relationship with Russia?
Energy is everything. Energy is everything. So listen, right now there is not, you know, like 70 years ago when NATO first formed, the threat, of course, was a physically Russia moving west and taking over territory there. That threat is no longer there. However, whether it's cyber or whether it's energy policy, you can essentially hold countries hostage by those things. So again, I don't agree with the president stylistically, but I think he's correct in that it does undermine Europe. It does undermine the alliance, if you will, if Germany becomes more and more reliant on energy from Russia, therefore filling their coffers with a bunch of money, but also being beholden to them. You have seen in the past where Russia's turned the gas off through Ukraine. So I think the president actually has a very valid point there, although I may not agree on the delivery, if you will.
Final two questions for you, just quickly on Turkey. There's been a lot of reports that have surfaced with regards to how the Turkish administration is purchasing weapons and military defense systems from Russia. What do you make of that in the context of what we're talking about now?
I think it's a big problem. Yep. Turkey is an ally. They're a NATO ally of ours. You got to choose. Do you want the F-35s, which is the best plane in the world, the most advanced fighter with us, or do you want those S-400s from Russia? So I think they need to choose. I'm concerned about Turkey. They are our ally, and I think that we should have an alliance with them. However, I'm definitely concerned about a breadth of issues with Turkey, with the elections and, you know, with journalists, with jailing opponents on trumped-up charges and things like that. I'm definitely concerned about them purchasing S-400s from Russia. I think it's incompatible with our systems. It wouldn't be long before the information from the F-35s would get to potentially Russia, so then they could tweak the S-400s to combat the F-35s. So I have a big problem with it, and I think Turkey needs to choose.
I want to switch continents to Asia. Last question for you. The president's trade negotiations with China, in terms of how it would seemingly suggest there's unification, bipartisan unification with regards to intellectual property, but there doesn't seem to be as much with how he's negotiating other aspects of the trade deal. Do you have any concerns at all with how the president is negotiating with China?
I think anytime you have a war, whether it's physical or a trade war or whatever it is, there are concerns. There are potential for unintended consequences. There's no question about there. And in trade, some people will be helped, some people will be hurt. But at the same time, this is also an uncomfortable truth that China's been cheating, that China's been stealing intellectual property, that they have harmed the United States in terms of trade and other countries around the world. So I think that Americans largely want someone to step up and say, hey, enough is enough. We're going to deal with China. Now, that's uncomfortable. And listen, he may very well fail in some respects, but I think that we have to give this president space to be able to do what Americans put him in office for, and to stand up to a China that has a crazy trade imbalance with us and that's stealing our intellectual property, that are trying to rise and become the power in the world. I'd rather America stay as the power in the world. So I'd like to give this president space to be able to do what I think is in the best interest of this United States.